Okay, guys, I apologize that this has been so long. I had a lot of footage on my rack and pinion. I had a lot of footage for the skid plate, a lot of things. And I was going to edit them, put them together. And, of course, my phone ends up having an update, has some issues after that, and I've lost a lot of footage, or a lot of footage is all, like, scrambled and messed up. So, fortunately, I am going to do a rack and pinion video, but it's just going to be a walkthrough of how to do it. And I'll get under the car and show you, but I'm not actually going to be doing it because I'm not going to do that job again unless I absolutely have to. And then this is just going to be how to do the skid plate, but it's already on the vehicle. But this is really, really pretty easy. So it's four bolts and it's not too bad at all. So basically you'll get the gist of everything you need with this. So I have the HRG, the Honda Rescue Garage skid plate on, along with my Black Horse bull bar. And it actually fits really good. So what I had to do is you'll have four mounting points, and I had to get the spacers, if you look right there, to lower my bar. And the reason why I had to do that is because, one, the body drop, an engine drop, and two, the aftermarket header. Your stock header, it will clear fine with no body drop. If you do not have a body drop or engine drop, and you have an aftermarket header, you are probably still going to need some spacers and let Ben know that. Will you need an inch and a half? No, you probably just need like an inch or smaller if you're, you know, stock other than a header. So make sure you guys pay attention to note that, because he's not going to know that unless you, you know, tell him something. Now you see the scratches this thing has already took going through, and I mean how tough this thing is. I mean, it wobbles a little up here. I could put something here to stop it, but it doesn't hit and vibrate, thankfully, so I don't need to do that. But you have the useless bar, as he likes to call it, but this one's not so useless. It is pretty freaking thick if you take a look at it there. So I have it with the spacers. I did this myself with extra spacers he sent me. Now, when he starts probably producing more of these, or you custom order it, however he sets it up, he's probably going to have a little bit better bolt washer kit and things like that for you. So just remember, but you're going to have to, you know, let him know that, because otherwise these are just going to be made by one way and they're not going to be, you know, custom fit for your drop, your header, whatever you have. So you're going to have to let him know that. Now, if you have an engine drop, here's another point where you're going to have to let him know, or you're going to have to bench grind it yourself. I believe he is going to, see this bracket? I believe he's going to make them where they're smooth like this, but I'm not 100% sure. It was something we talked about, and I let him know, because otherwise this sticks out, and it does. It will rub right on that axle. It doesn't touch while you're sitting still, but any driving, vibration, anything, it will rub right against that axle. And grinding the axle cause a vibration here, and that's with the engine drop. Without the engine drop, I believe you're fine. You'd have to ask him, but I believe it does not hit. Still, I think it's better to just grind it down. So you'll want to get a bench grinder, or ever how you're going to do it, or a wheel cutter, however you want to do it, and cut right there. So you're going to want to smooth it like a half moon shape, basically, and round it off. And as you can see here, same thing on the other side. All it is a bolt goes through, and if you see that bolt head, it's just a bolt and a nut, and you have three ways of adjusting it. And I have it on the lowest setting, or the highest setting in the front, lowest in the rear. Now, that may look silly, the reason why you ask. I can move it higher up in the rear, and I probably will down the road, but I want to be able to get to change my oil. And if you look at the angle of that plug, and you look at that, if I have it up on my highest setting, it is going to be a pain in the ass to get in there to change my oil. So I'm going to try to figure out a little like drain plug or something I can put on there, or a little like cup to catch it and drain it eventually. Or if I'm feeling real adventurous, I may even cut a piece of the skid plate out and then rivet like different places, or at least put different areas where I can bolt like nice fender washers or something, and then unbolt it when I need to, so I can get to that that oil drain plug a little bit easier. Because I just don't want to have to take all four bolts off this thing every single time. If you can see, there's the four bolts. That one's a little harder to see back there. But yeah, it mounts on each side to your front lower control arm, the inner bolt, and that's going to be the bracket. And guys, this thing's tough as hell. Like, it is bolted in there. You hear the entire car, you know, rattles if you hit this sucker. It is not, it's not going nowhere. And then you have these three or four bolts right to connect the two pieces of the skid plate together. What's going to make your life a lot easier, I found out, and Ben let me know this, is that you are going to want to bolt these on first and make the skid plate all one piece, not very tight, you know, a little loose, and then you're going to want to line up your spots. So when you line up your spots and you get everything lined up, then you start tightening everything all at once. It's a pain in the ass. Don't try to put this on and then get these bolts in, because I tried that and it is a pain in the ass. So yeah, that's pretty much it. And it will fit with a bull bar, guys. It will fit with, I would say, pretty much any bull bar. But, you know, there are some out there that, you know, are different. So, you know, that's kind of buy at your own risk. But I can tell you, with the Black Horse bull bar, it's awesome. It will fit, and I like it with the Black Horse skid plate that it already has there built into it. And then that one behind it, I kind of think it looks, gives it like a good backdrop, and it just adds extra protection. And looks better to me than a big gaping hole in between where the skid plate drops down. So yeah, that's how to do the HRG skid plate. It is not scary at all, guys, not hard at all. Your biggest thing is if he doesn't have those new brackets for the, where you got to grind down inside for the control arms, is if you have a body drop or engine drop, you're going to need to do that. You're going to have to get a bench grinder, a wheel cutter, something that you're comfortable with grinding those down until he has his new ones, which I'm pretty sure he's probably going to finish through his old stock. That would make sense. And then eventually make his new brackets. So, yeah, that's it, guys. It's not too bad. If you have any questions, just ask me in the comment. You want any personal pictures, hit me up on my Instagram at crv_tom. Please like this video, subscribe, share, guys, help me out. I'm halfway to starting to make some money off of this, and if I do, that's going to leave me to do more things with all these projects for you guys, more things to teach, more things to do, things for me to learn, to show you guys. And I like to do things like, I have, that's the new blue CRV I got. I don't know what I'm going to do with it yet, but I can do fun things like, let's see what a stock CRV can make it through and put it through hell, and, you know, just do some cool, interesting videos. So the more, you know, help I get from you guys, the more thumbs up, the more subscribes, the more, you know, shares, bigger things are going to come. I'm trying to get there. This 2020 year, I'm sure all of you guys know, is really, it's kind of thrown everything off. So yeah, if you can help me out, guys, I'd appreciate that. And then more videos will be coming soon.